Prologue, a formal introduction to Stop the Ride, I Want to Get Off by Dave Courtney.
Hello people, my name's Dave Courtney. I'm now classed by the media as a celebrity gangster. I'd like to say first of all there is no such thing, it is a contradiction of words. It's like saying police intelligence, the two words just don't go. Everyone has a price. Everyone. Yeah.
Narrated by David Clark.
In this video, Dave Courtney tells you about himself. Then I, Dave Clark, tell you why I contacted him.
My name's Dave Courtney.
Despite whatever you've heard of me, I'm worse. This was my opening address to a jury during one of my trials. And I could have added, whatever you may already think I've done, is true and more. But I didn't, of course, because I wanted to get a not guilty. My words were enough to set the scene for my own defence, although my defence team were pretty shocked by what I said. Dodgy Dave, Bermondsey boy, the people's villain, the yellow pages of crime, heir to the craze, a right cunt. Now, finally, I've finished with being an active criminal. I've stopped the ride. I've got off. But it was a bloody good ride while it lasted, and this book you're holding in your hand is your ticket to it. So, enjoy the read.
The only DJ that can call me. Always trust your instincts.
Yeah, yeah.
It's nice to be important, but important to be nice. So be nice.
The artful, dodgy Dave Courtney.
Always trust your instincts.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So it is written by Dave Courtney. And now to David Clark. David is the father of six children.
Oh, I've got a helmet. I got a beauty.
Isaac is the eldest, followed by Esther, David and Ellie, Becky and finally, Maisie. He published his first book Converted on LSD Trip on the 11th of February 2001, which was exactly 30 years to the day of the story appearing as headline news in Aylesbury's Bucks Herald newspaper. David had been converted during a bad LSD trip, after watching this classic movie, Easy Rider. And so after 40 years he is back, intending to share his life's experience with others, in order to help divert young people from crime to riding. Or with the help of South Sea Riders. Now listen to a sample of David's book, Converted on LSD Trip, narrated by David himself. This is just another example of writing to help our writers put their stories to print.
Confession to 24 crimes. It was real, absolutely real, but none of my friends really believed me. All I could do was tell them what had happened to me, and that was what I did. I told them all, the long, the short, and the tall, as many of them as I could. They thought I'd gone mad after taking LSD. Jesus Christ had spoken to me and rescued me from a bad trip on LSD on the 16th of January, 1970. He had said that what you'd been going through was nothing compared to what hell was like. I now knew the way and was determined to tell others. I had become a Christian and no longer needed to live the lifestyle that I'd adopted, which had involved crime, drugs, promiscuity, flash cars, fame. I'd been born again. I was now responsible for sorting out all the stolen gear I had. What could be done with the builder's shed, which had been stolen one night from the building site in Berkhamsted, and a lovely G Register Mini stolen from Hemel Hempstead, which was in the process of being run. Ringing meant replacing the old Mini with a legitimate registration document from an older car and its number plates. The new Mini was being used to replace my old one. This was to be my new car. I also had a Mini Minor Traveller, which had been rung and was being used as a hire car. Electric welding equipment, spray guns and trolley jacks. I had several pieces of stolen electrical gear, which included oscilloscopes, avometers, colour televisions. I had all my garage equipment, all the garage equipment that I needed to spray cars. I had a lovely Citroen DS in the builder's shed, which was being repaired. I obtained this through swapping it for a colour TV set. The only problem was that I'd stolen the colour TV set from the old people's home in Winslow, Buckinghamshire. I'd also two nice speedboat engines getting ready for the summer in 1970. All in all, I had a really good time, full of excitement and fun. In fact, I've been stopped in the midst of my career, which involves stealing all kinds of goods to have a good time. I intended to have a caravan, a speedboat, water skis, aqualung diving gear,
motorbikes, clothes, all through stealing. I was in fact stopped in the midst of my career, but not by the police.
It was by Jesus Christ who had called me by name, and I followed him. I thank God he intervened again in my life a year later, and his hand was clearly seen once more. I had no one else to help. As I write this now, I take encouragement from the fact that God is faithful and was faithful to me in never leaving me nor forsaking me. I realise now I was kept through the power and grace of the Lord Jesus Christ to bear witness today to many people of the goodness and mercy of God to me.
So, what's the story? My brother Michael Clark and I were both notorious young criminals in the 60s and were sent to prison for carrying a firearm without a license. But he died of tuberculosis, like you would if you had COVID, in New Bilibid Prison in the Philippines after serving 10 years of a 16-year prison sentence in 2005. But not before he too had called out to the Lord Jesus for salvation, just like I did some 30 years previously. And we both believed that no one is too far off from God stepping in to save a sinner from his sins. In this case, Dave Courtney. He knows why I visited him. Now read the whole story in our two books, and such were some of you, in two editions, available from amazon.co.uk and amazon.com.